Well, 'tis the season for Knights of Lights. The large traditional holiday display is on full display right now in St. Augustine.
And it's a holiday display that thousands travel to see every year, Heather. But as On Your Side's Haley Harrison found out tonight, the crowds that the spectacle attracts could be a concern in this pandemic.
The weekend before Thanksgiving is usually the first weekend of Knights of Lights, but the city actually lit up the display last weekend in hopes of spreading out the crowds. However, as you can see, downtown is still packed with visitors, and just from what I've noticed tonight, only about half are wearing masks.
It's a holiday tradition First Coast families should be cautious about this year. Baptist Health Chief Physician Executive Dr. Elizabeth Ransom explains.
A lot of people in close proximity and not wearing masks, there's definitely a risk there. It's not, of course, as high as if all those people were inside, but still being that close with a lot of people, that's risky.
She says a way families can enjoy the lights while staying safe is driving through the display in their cars. City of St. Augustine spokesperson Melissa Whistle admits the challenge is making sure visitors are wearing masks without a mandate enforcing them to. However, the city is relaunching its mask initiative and has begun distributing signs to businesses on St. George Street, reminding visitors to mask up.
Whistle says the city will be putting up additional signage next week in areas where people walk around and see the lights. In St. Augustine, Haley Harrison, First Coast News, On Your Side.